I think I came into med school with a unique perspective and a knowledge that most medical schools, about half of the medical schools in the U.S., include some form of disability awareness or disability curricula in their med school. And so a lot of medical students are graduating without this knowledge. And with wanting to leave this place better than I found it, I wanted to make sure that myself and my future colleagues were prepared to care for all individuals, whether or not they had a disability. And so I knew that one way I could do that would be to create the curricula that doesn't exist and to create this disability health curriculum. When I connected with Dr. DeWater, she was super supportive of this idea and very honest of she has the medical education experience. I didn't have that, but I had the disability experience. And how can we work together to create something that's going to impact the education of myself and my future colleagues? The first time it was implemented was in spring 2022 for my class of first year medical students, and it included three components. The first component was a 15-minute video that introduced disability, the language to talk about disability and different models of disability. The second component was Adept Care, which was a teaching tool mnemonic I developed with a team of medical students, some who live with disabilities and colleagues and mentors, some who also live with disabilities. And the Adept Care mnemonic talks about how to do a comprehensive history and physical exam for patients with disabilities. And then the third component was viewing a documentary about the disability rights movement and completing a reflection piece. I've been thankful to collaborate with the Penn State Health Office of Diversity and Inclusion, and we've adapted the Adept Care training for all patient-facing employees. And so we sent the Adept Care training to 14,000 patient-facing employees across the health system, and 91% or 13,000 of them took this voluntary training, which I just can't wrap my head around these numbers sometimes, but it just shows me that there's such a desire of this community to learn this information, and I'm just happy to be in a place to help disseminate it. We are Penn State College of Curiosity and Innovative Medicine.